Hey again, Steady On here. It's been a while. My monetization got removed by Google, well, YouTube, but thanks to AlbumLux, who helped me get it back, and I'm making videos again now. That whole thing's over. There wasn't, as far as I can tell, any reason for you to be on it, for me to be demonetized, but that's not the point of this video. So in this video, we're going to be creating a lifting game. This will actually be a two or three part series, maybe even more than that, and this episode will be on creating the tool that you use to lift, animating the tool, playing the animations, and that should be pretty much it for this tutorial, for this episode. I'll talk about what the other episodes are later, or I might not talk about them at all, actually. You'll probably be able to see them they'll be in a playlist. So if you don't know what a lifting game is, you've got stuff like Weightlifting Simulator, so there's Weightlifting Simulator 1, 2, 3, and then there's my friend Shoefaze made quite a lot of these. His main ones are Dominus Lifting Simulator, where you lift a Dominus up and down. I mean, I personally don't really like playing these games. They're not very fun, to me. But they seem very popular, and I don't think anyone's made a tutorial on how to make them yet, and they're quite simple to make. So let's get right into it. So we're going to create a tool to start with. So all we need to do is insert into the starter pack a tool. I mean, call this whatever we want, but for the sake of the tutorial, we'll just call it object, because this is whatever object we're lifting up. Now, into this, we want to insert a part, and every tool can take one part called handle, and it will automatically be connected to the player's hand. So, we also don't really want it to be too big, so we're going to make this a one stud squared part. Okay. So just to quickly show what this does, I mean, I'm not going to do this everything I add, but just in case you're unsure what happens when you make a handle. So we've now got this. Whatever you're doing, you can just attach a mesh to this part, and you can lift wherever you want. So obviously when I click right now, nothing's happening. I can't do anything. There's no statistics here or anything like that. I'm just going to reduce this resolution a bit. Okay. So what we want to do first is we want to create a animation. So you need the animation plugin from Roblox. It's very easy to do. To download it, you just need to go to Manage Plugins, Find Plugins, and then you just go to this search bar here once it loads, and you want to search for animation. I can't remember what the second bit is, but just search anyway. Oh, what is it? Roblox animation. If we can't find it here, I'll just go to the Roblox account. Yeah. Okay, so we want to go to the Roblox account then. Let's go to the Roblox account just to make sure it's the real plugin. We're gonna go to the oh. You can't go to the inventory. Okay. Basically, you want to download the animation plugin from Roblox. I think it's called Animation Editor. I mean, this isn't made by Roblox. I don't know if it is it though. This might be it. It's called Animation Editor. I'll put it in the description. Oh, you can find it here, I think. Not really sure, to be honest. Anyway, so we're going to create a animation. So the first thing you want to do is click on the Rig Builder, and you want to create a rig. I'll just use a block rig. Okay. So once you've got the plugin, what you're going to want to do is click on Animation Editor. You want to click and select your rig, and then you want to start making keyframes. So we want our character here to be lifting an object. So I've set the time length to 1 second, so it will take 1 second per lift. Although I'm not sure one, I'm lifting in my own in real life. I think we should make it 2 seconds. So 1 second to lift, 1 second to put it back down again. So all we need to do is just make it go to 1 second, and then we make the character be in the position we want it to be in. So you can enable this thing called IK, which means that you get these. It basically predicts and keeps a sort of natural looking movement with the player. So you can see as I rotate this torso, the legs move with it as well, so it looks natural as a real human being would do it. So let's just move this back again to how it was. Okay, so when the player lifts something, they're probably going to be looking at what they're lifting. It's going to be in this hand here, and their arm's going to move up, of course, as they lift. I'm not sure, the hand won't move, I don't think, really. But as they lift, they're probably going to go up to about here. They might brace their legs, like probably like this sort of thing. There we go. I mean, you can make this however you want it to be. It's your animation, of course. So you can see that when I try and bend the leg forward too far, the IK stops me, because a human wouldn't be able to do that usually. All right. So we'll just put this there because it's dangling at the side. And now we've got our keyframe here. We're going to add another keyframe at the end, and what this keyframe is going to be is the player back straight again. Okay, so if we now run this, you can see that we've just got the player going back to its original position. But what this will mean is that if the player is doing something before they click, like they're walking or something, then the animation they're already running will tween into this animation here, this position. So it means that, because if we'd started off with a set position, the player would suddenly stand completely still, and it looks kind of unnatural. So by leaving this 1 second blank, it means that whatever the player is doing before this 1 second starts, that position will be animated into the lifting animation. So now we're going to export this. So we're going to press export after file. Let's ignore all those animations I've got there. And we'll call it lifting animation. Okay. And then right here, it gives us the actual asset ID. Although, I don't know if I trust that, it doesn't look like asset ID to me. So here we go, yeah. So we're going to paste it in Chrome, or whatever web browser you use, web browser of choice. Copy this ID here, that's the animation ID. And we can just close this now, because we've already saved it. If you want to, you can save it to file. I'm not going to do that, because it's just for a tutorial. And we can delete the dummy as well. Now, let's go back to the tool. And in the tool, we're going to create a local script. So we just go insert and find local script, and we'll call this lifting core. It should really be called something like client lifting core, because it's a script on the client side. It's a local script, which means it's client-sided. So let's get the tool object, I'll call it, equals script parent, because that's this object here. And we want to detect when it's equipped. And the way you can do that is we can assign a variable, we can call it equipped. And obviously at the beginning it's not going to be equipped. But what we do is we say equipped, that's an event, connect, function. So we create a function. So whenever the object is equipped, we get this function, and we change the variable equipped to true. And we do and right now, every time it's equipped, it will turn to true. But whenever it's unequipped, it won't turn to false. So there's nothing to compare it against. So we need to say object.unequipped connect function. And then we assign equipped to false, like this. So now we've got this done. We can now say whether or not, when the player clicks, they should lift something up. They should play the animation. So to detect when someone clicks, you want to get the player's mouse. And to do that, we say, we need to first find their player object. So we say local player equals game dot players dot local player. And that's the player who's running this script, the player whose tool it is. Then we're going to create another another variable, which is the player's mouse. So we just say player get mouse. That's the function. And it gets us the player's mouse for later use, which we will use later on for clicking, click detection. Now what we're going to do is we're going to assign mouse click. So we're going to say mouse dot. I actually can't remember what the what the function is. I don't really prepare for these tutorials. I'm just making this on the spot. If it isn't obvious already, sorry about that. I'm just so very busy with making games and stuff. I'm trying to do this. I'm trying to get all the as many videos as I can in. And planning videos takes a long time. So mouse button one down gives us it is fired when the person clicks their left mouse. So what we're going to want to do is we say if equipped, then. We could also put here if equipped equals true, and that would be the exact same thing. But instead we're just going to put if equipped, which is up here it says equipped equals true. And if equipped is true, so this is the same as just saying if equipped is true, then we do something here. And what we're going to do here is run the lifting animation. And we haven't defined a variable for that. So let's quickly define a variable for the lifting animation. So local lifting ID equals, we're going to paste that ID we got from earlier from this page. No, it's not there. I don't know where it is actually. But remember, we copied that ID from the animation and the animation page. And we're going to put RBX asset ID before it, because it's a Roblox asset. And then we're going to paste the ID we got from earlier for that animation. Now, we're going to want to also create an animation object. So we're going to say local animation equals instance.new. And this is creating a new instance, which is an animation. And we want to parent this animation. Oh, sorry, no, actually, we don't want to parent the animation. We want to change the ID of the animation to the lifting ID we just created here, this variable we just assigned here. And this is the animation we'll be playing every time the player clicks their mouse. So once we've done that, down here is where we create the loading of the animation. So we say local lift anim for lifting animation is player.character.humanoid, because we need the humanoid of our local player to be able to run an animation. Load animation, and we're going to take our animation we got from earlier that we just created, just up here. And this doesn't do it by itself. We also have to run the animation. So we say lift anim play. So what this should do is every time we click, it should play that lifting animation. Let's have a look. So press one, click, and you can see that I lifted it up. It's not very obvious, I'll admit. I could have made that a bit more, it kind of just looks like they've got an electric shock or something. So now we've created our animation. That's only a very small part, really, of what we're going to want to do. I'm going to close this. So we created our tool, which runs the animation. I think that might be all I was going to do in this tutorial, wasn't it? This episode. Okay, so there we go. We've created our tool, and we've run an animation on it. You can see that the animation works for the player. So tune in next time for the next installment of this series on how to make a Roblox lifting simulator, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.